Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we'll see the connection between imines and the synthesis of secondary amines. The connection is the reductive amination. Across the top of the screen is a conversion of a ketone to an alcohol with a reducing agent like sodium borohydride or lithium aluminum hydride. This reaction is closely related to a reductive amination. On the bottom of the screen is a pair of reactions. First is the formation of an imine from reaction of a primary amine with a ketone and loss of water. The second step is the reduction of the imine CN pi bond with sodium borohydride. You could also use lithium aluminum hydride or even hydrogen and palladium on carbon. Notice what happens overall in this process. We start with a primary amine and finish with a secondary amine through reduction of an imine. This overall process is called a reductive amination. The reductive amination is perhaps the most common way to make secondary amines, and it requires a primary amine as the starting material. In the far upper left corner is a simple secondary amine. Let's make it from a nitrogen source, like ammonia or sodium azide. We'll start by adding one of the R groups to the nitrogen to get a primary amine. Then we'll use a reductive amination to add the other R group and finish with a secondary amine. Let's use azide for our nitrogen source and put on the cyclohexyl group first. So we'll react cyclohexyl bromide with sodium azide in an SN2 reaction. To make the azide, we've now made one of our CN bonds, but we need to reduce the azide to get our primary amine. Once we have a primary amine, we can react it. We'll continue on a second line. React it with a carbonyl compound. And in this case, we want to use a carbonyl compound that contains all the carbons of the alkyl group that we're going to need. These will react to form an imine. We can then treat our imine in our last step with sodium borohydride to make our secondary amine. That's it. We've made a secondary amine. Looking in the far upper right, we could have added the R groups in a different order. In the SN2 alkylation with azide, we could have used benzyl bromide. The carbonyl for the imine would then need to be cyclohexanone. This alternative approach would work just as well as the first. That is the reductive amination. It is one of the standard methods for making secondary amines from primary amines.